Hello everyone, this is HS Yeska here, and it is time for some more League of Legends. We're going to be going in try-hard mode. I'll talk about that in just a second, but I'm here with Simvicta. Why, hello there.
Hello, Husky. How have you been on this fine evening? Oh, it looks like the game has already started, but I'm looking forward. It's been a little while since we've done Try Hard, and I think we're going to be in good shape. We've got to support Zyra with Graves, and you are now pro MLG status with Graves. Now that you and Dyrus are BFFs, and
Yeah, I got to train with Dyrus for about an hour, so of course that gets me in the mood to go crush all the noobs with my newfound knowledge, and I'll probably actually be absolutely terrible. But this is going to be try hard, where we actually try and win with what we're given, and yeah, so it'll be less about fancy commentary and more about trying to win. Of course, I am at least super, super bad, so the decisions I may be making might not actually be the best.
Well, both of us. Well, I'm not going to speak for Mr. Husky, but everybody knows how terrible I am. And apparently Pantheon's saying he's never used Pantheon before, and Katarina
So
is
much
also
more to
flipping
see
his
than
you know
you
what because
saw.
he who doesn't know Husky at this point? I mean, let's be honest. He's such a staple in the League of Legends community, and
Yeah, no, I've been around there since the long-lost days of 2 weeks
wait until
ago.
my seeds
Really,
take
really, I
root.
think, made a name for myself in this game. But I'm actually kind of excited. I'm going to be playing Graves. That's who Dyrus recommended I play. So I'm going to practice a couple games as him. And I kind of like him a lot. I thought I was
Foremost
going to
holds
be
many
a
surprises.
maybe a melee player, but I'm kind of
Yields
liking
have
Graves.
fallen.
Really, actually, a lot of the range characters are kind of funny. Who are you playing? You look like you're playing like Ivy or someone.
Yeah, almost Poison Ivy. Her name is
Take
actually Zyra.
careful
I
steps.
usually play her as a not really an offensive carry, but just pretty much offensively minded. I do have to thank my friend the Angry Honey Badger, who's also on YouTube, and he has been teaching me the ways of playing support Zyra.
Just
And
a
actually, one of the more
harmless
stronger
flower.
combinations is Zyra supporting Ashe. And since Graves is technically not Ashe, obviously he's a little bit more manlier, but Graves is a very very good ranged DPS character, and I am
Come
looking
closer.
forward to letting you have all the CS and pretty much all the kills too.
I'm definitely okay with that. That is for sure. So we got the little we got the little spearman over
Yeah,
here.
Pantheon and Kog'Maw. You have to look out for Kog'Maw. He is what's known as I call them an auto attack hero, and
Watch out
basically
for
his
beaten
basic attacks
paths.
are going to be the biggest source of his DPS. I could probably land a root on one of them if you wanted to go in on them.
Wait, hang on. I got it on cooldown.
Okay.
And okay, it's
Honestly,
off cooldown if
God.
you want to try it.
All right, I'm gonna see what I can do here, and we're gonna be focusing on maybe one of them, maybe. Nope. All right. Well, we've got actually Pantheon's gonna be trying to run back here. I don't know if that's the
Venture
right
out
option,
the
but
beaten
definitely am taking a
path.
lot of damage from the creep. But we don't have to worry about too much right now. We did damage him pretty heavily, and actually my root is back up again, Husky. If you oh, sorry, I'm not. I forgot to put myself on hold position there.
The forest
All right.
holds
So I do
many
have now
surprises.
level two. So yeah, if you wanna root him anytime, that's totally fine by me.
Okay, I'm gonna let the wave push back a little bit, so we're not running into their
Just
tower.
a
Then I will go
harmless
for a root.
flower.
I haven't seen them ward anything yet, and oh, that's that acidic goo, and that will actually slow you down. I don't remember if Kog'Maw's ability actually causes a debuff, like stacking debuff dot with that, but I know that it does slow you down. It's pretty nasty.
So much
Pantheon's
more
actually
to
going to be coming
see.
in the bush down here, and I'm going to go ahead and land a root. He's going to jump on me, and I'm going to see if I can land. Oh, I didn't land the exhaust. That's all right. That's all right. I had to burn barrier, but I did keep exhaust. So
First blood.
it looks like Fiddlesticks gets a kill on our Pantheon, so that
Wait
is good.
until my seeds take root.
Oh, we got towers killing people all over the place.
Yeah. So they're just going to be hanging out near their tower. Let's get behind the. We should probably get
Things
behind the
aren't
creep here. Pantheon
always
can
what
actually
they seem.
charge.
Dude, I got this. I got this.
Yeah,
I
you.
didn't know that he could charge though, so I'm not gonna do that again.
Well, he can leap, but it's quite nasty. I'm more worried about Kog'Maw's ult when he actually gets it. Kog'Maw's ult, he can cast
Constant
anywhere.
Garden.
Well, not anywhere, but it's one of those skill shots where you can just aim it and then predict where someone's going to be. It has a very, very long range and it hits very hard. But he's on level 3 right now, so we don't have to really worry about it too much. Looking like top is missing, although I think
Come
Fiddlesticks executed
closer.
himself. And again, you're not going to be seeing, at least from not my point of view, you're not going to be seeing a whole lot of action because, again, I am supporting Husky here. And my job is to set him up for the kills, give him the CS, and hopefully we can might get a kill on Pantheon here, maybe? Let's see what we can do here. And Pantheon's going to come... Oh, he got a little bit too close. Too close there. They know that I'm in the bush. We definitely have to be careful of the creep damage here. Level 4. And I got to say, support, even though no one likes playing support, everyone likes to win. I feel like support's just kind of lazy. I just kind of let you do all the work, and I just set you up. I'm kind of like the pitcher, really. And we are going to get Pantheon there in the root. Don't quite do much damage to him. That's all right.
I have a feeling I'm beating them in creep score pretty heavily, though.
Your CS is sitting at 23. Yeah, you're dominating both of them. They're sitting at Pantheon's sitting at 5 CS. Kog'Maw's only at 14. So yeah, you are dominating them right now.
Okay. I feel like we haven't killed them yet, but at the same time, as long as I'm killing little guys, that's good.
Yep. You are the carry down here, sir, and I am. You're not very heavy. I'm pretty sure I can carry you pretty easily.
Yeah, and I'm not wearing my armor or anything like that. I'm basically in my beach attire, so that doesn't weigh me down any.
All right, so we got Kog'Maw approaching here. I put one of my deadly blooms in the bushes there just so we give it a little bit of vision. It's good as a little temporary ward there.
Take care.
And I'm gonna see if I can sneak up behind them, Husky, and we could probably. Oh, no, they're going to be pushing back. I don't know if they actually warded this bush. I didn't see them warded, but that's all right.
So much more to see.
So we can't really dive in on them right now because they're too close to their turret.
It's all right. I'll just keep slowly shooting them. Yep. That's what they want.
I did get Kog'Maw there, but we got to get out of that adhesive. Yeah. Going to go ahead and back off a little bit. And actually, with my barrier coming up in 9 seconds, I could probably dive them and execute myself to go back. I don't know if that's going to be the right decision or not, though.
I'm low on health and mana, so I'm going to kind of do that auto-attacking.
I'm going to go ahead and root both of them here, just make them think about what they did. Kog'Maw is really, really low. Oh, he just got out of the way of that shot from yours. Oh, that would have been nice. All right. I'm gonna go back real quick just to get some wards, because they're both low enough to where you're gonna be fine, unless you go into the. Right. Just watch out for the jungler.
Yeah. All right. Looks like they left. We were almost able to kill them. I feel like so far this is okay, even though we're three behind. I feel like our lane's not doing too bad.
Yeah, we're holding our. I mean, if you take a look at the creep score, you're at 34 right now, and Pantheon's at 8. Kog'Maw is only at 22, so you are beating them both, and they had to go back, so we forced them back. I'm on my way right now. Run, Husky, run.
Oh, he ain't got nothing.
It's a good thing he doesn't have his ult yet.
He ain't got nothing. I'm probably going to go back too, now that you're here.
Yep. Venture, go for it. I'm going to ward. I'll ward when you get back, let's put it that way.
I almost have enough for that fancy sword, but not quite yet. This is going to give me lifesteal, though, which is quite nice. And I'm going to go ahead and grab some pots. And I'm going to grab that. I may have gotten weird item choices, but at least I have... See, it's attack speed and damage with lifesteal.
It's not weird, it's just misunderstood.
True that. There you go, there's your creep score.
Yep, I'm trying
Let's beef that up.
Trying to get a little bit of CS here while you're not here. And I think I got one out of that entire group, so that's good. I do have my ult now, though, and that is definitely a big deal.
I will say, it does look like their Warwick has still not connected, so we have that going for us.
All right, Graves is back
here. What we lack in experience, we make up for in good luck.
It's not about the motion in the ocean, the size of the boat. I don't know how that saying goes.
I mean, that sounded about right.
I'm gonna go ward up here real quick, and that is the ultimate from Kog'Maw. That little, you see that red line, laser line. He can fire that off pretty much anytime he wants, and it does a lot of damage.
The force.
Gotcha.
Be a little bit careful. I'm gonna say that Pantheon is actually missing down here. Yep, there's his ult.
Does it have a cooldown, or how does that work?
It's a very, very short cooldown. It costs a lot of mana, but it's a very short cooldown on his ult. And I'm going to say that, heads up, Pantheon is coming towards mid. So since Pantheon's up top, he's actually going to be swinging around, I think, Husky. If Pantheon guard. Comes around the river, we could probably turn that around and flank him. So
yeah, I don't see him. I don't know where he's hanging out.
Yeah, he's somewhere. I don't think he's a dragon. I'm pretty sure a level 6
just
Pantheon can't soul
a
dragon. Although that I need to be warding there, too. I'm going to go buy an extra ward whenever the next time I go back so I can ward dragon. But in the meantime, I'm just going to let Husky do all the work, and I'm just going to soak up the XP.
Take careful
typical
steps.
Sinvicta.
Yep. I am just I'm a lazy gamer. Oh, there's Pantheon. I did see him. He's at Tribush right now.
An ally has been slain.
And down goes our Pantheon again. So, looking at right now, our Pantheon, the guy who said he's never played Pantheon, is currently 0-3.
0-3. All right, I feel like that evens things up a little bit. You know, we feed him a little bit. They're down a champion.
Yep, there's Kog'Maw using that adhesive on me. There's his ult as well.
Do I have to move out of it, or does it just do direct damage?
No, you have to. You can move out of it. Just dodge it. You'll see the laser sight come out. And actually, Husky, if your ult is ready, I'm going to go on them here and root
Let's
them as
it.
Much as I can. And lots of damage coming out. I am going to barrier here. We could get two kills here. Down goes Kog'Maw. Will Husky be able to get the kill on Pantheon? Yes, a double kill. Look out for Kog'Maw, though. Oh, I get killed by the corpse. Oh, damn it. I forgot about Kog'Maw's ability. Oh, yeah, so that will remind me to tell you that Kog'Maw has an ability when he dies. His body is actually reanimated temporarily, and it will do a huge damage. That is his passive. And I actually forgot about that. So there's Fiddlesticks using not Crowstorm. Lee Sin's actually going to look like he's going to help you out. Actually, Katarina comes out of nowhere as well. She has both the red and blue buff. That's going to be nice for you. I guess they're not going to dive in on Fiddlesticks. Fiddlesticks is quite scary, by the way.
Yeah, no, he was blowing me up for sure.
And someone actually warded that. If you ever, Husky, if you ever actually get to the point where you're warding for somebody, that ward placement right in front of Dragon that someone threw there that's usually the most important ward spot besides Tribush in their jungle. That's something that I learned from my very, very short League of Legends career, if you even want to call it that. They are in the bushes right here.
All right. I do like that word placement. Oh, so Fiddlesticks is over here.
Yep. And I'm actually Pantheon's actually going to try to run in from the side, and I've got Pantheon in a 1v1. Actually, Kog'Maw's behind me as well. Run, Zyra. I'm going to try to do as much damage as I can.
We at least killed one, so it wasn't the worst exchange in the world.
Lee Sin might get a kill on Pantheon, hopefully. Did you actually die?
Yeah, no, I died.
Oh, good, nice. Lee Sin
seems like that drain ability is really good.
Yeah, you wanna not fight Fiddlesticks one on one, not without your support anyway.
So, all right, well, hey, at least I can buy one of the things I was wanting, so I'm okay with that.
Man, that's my second death there. The first death, that shouldn't happen to me. The second death, was just pretty... I did not realize that Kog'Maw was down there. And someone did. Lee Sin looks like he did ward their Tribush, which is good. I'm going to have to take a little bit of CS from me here just to clean up this tower.
It's all right. I'll allow it. That Kog'Maw kill was actually pretty sweet. I'll give him that.
Did he use his ult?
Yeah, he got him when he was running pretty far away from him.
Yeah, that thing has a crazy range. So we are going to push down here. I'm going to call Pantheon, their Pantheon missing. And let's see. I do want to ward. That dragon ward's still there. We actually have pretty good ward placements right now, so I'm not going to ward quite yet. But we are still missing their Pantheon down here. So looking at CS, Katarina's actually beating you. She's been solo top. And Pantheon just died to Pantheon, so there you go. We might actually get this turret here, I think. It's going to be close. We could probably push with this next wave. Wait for the wave.
It doesn't look like they're coming down to gank yet.
Yeah, if they're not coming down here, we're just going to push this tower, I guess.
Get that tower.
Yep. I'll let you get the... Actually, I don't think it matters who gets the last one on the tower. I think we all get 150 gold.
Yeah, I think we share it in this one.
So I'm going to take this opportunity to ward their jungle.
Seems like they returned the turret
Such
favor.
A busy world.
Yeah, they got the top turret. But I did get a ward in their jungle, which is good. Actually, they
I'm
have the...
kill some creeps.
They have the red buff up there, Husky. If you want to grab it, if you want to counter jungle. Although yeah, they're actually a lot of them are missing right now, so we might not be able to do that. And actually, MF is it MF? No, it's a. Is it Pantheon who's teleporting down here? Somebody was teleporting down here. I didn't see him.
Our team getting pwned.
Yeah, we should probably collapse in mid. Fiddlesticks definitely needs to be shut down. Venture off the beaten path. So Fiddlesticks is just gonna own. Yeah, and their Pantheon's up here. Let's get you the red buff, Husky. After
Wait,
you clean
I
up
want,
that creep down there.
I want this fatty creep score.
Yep. Come closer. Oh, you make sure I'm on the hold position.
All right, that actually wasn't too bad.
All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to tank. I'm going to have my plants and everything tank the big giant lizard here. And then make sure you get the last hit. There we go. And I'm going to back up. Use an ability if you have to get the last hit. Nice. So what that does is that gives you extra damage, and it also makes sure that your attacks cause a dot. But if you die, it transfers to the person who killed you, so...
All right, that has me a little bit worried. There's two guys down there. Wait, one just went north. I think Kog'Maw's kind of by himself. Oh, he's gone up north too.
We could probably let's go after Kog'Maw and see what we can do. I don't think they have their jungle warded.
So much more to see.
But just be careful of Ryze. Ryze is going to be the guy who's. Oh, there's Kog'Maw.
Kog'Maw's up here.
I'm coming. I'm running. Gonna root
kind of by himself.
Oh, I actually missed the root. Now goes the ult. I'm gonna ult everybody, see if I can stop them. Kog'Maw's gonna get away somehow. But Fiddlesticks and Ryze are still here. And get him, Katarina, get him! Get him! Yes! Oh, you got the kill too. Very nice. Awesome. We should push mid now. Let's go ahead and target that turret, get it down. If we do end up killing Kog'Maw, just remember about his body ability when he dies.
Yeah, what's it do again?
He can reanimate and it turns into a living bomb for like 5 seconds. You gotcha. Actually have the red and blue buff now, so your regen should be out of control right now. I'm gonna go ahead and see if I can root them, and let's go ahead and try to get you another kill here. Oh, there's barely missed it.
God, these buffs do last a while, huh?
Mm-hmm. They're worth
it. Nice.
Worth it. I'm gonna go ahead and put a pod there just so I can see. I still have one more ward.
Take careful steps.
And I wonder if we can get Dragon here. Let me see. Dragon is still up. Dragon just provides gold though. We can actually get killed. Here comes Fiddlesticks. Fiddlesticks gonna come around the side. And I think I rooted him maybe. Yeah, he's still up there if you see him.
Yeah, they're like all here. I'm a little bit.
Yeah, we should fall back.
A little bit terrified.
We should fall back to the turret.
A promising garden.
Alright, doesn't look like they want to... Oh.
They are moving towards bottom. They're going to try to gank our Pantheon, I think. Although, Fiddlesticks, they're coming up through the jungle. Back up to the turret. Back up.
Many surprises.
I rooted him. Go. I'm going to back out of that. Oh my god, so much damage. Katarina's going in hard.
So much more to see.
It's alright. Oh, that stupid Crowstorm thing. Backing out. Oh, blown up! And I think we're gonna get a kill on Kog'Maw. Run away from him! Run away from him if you can! You see his purple body right there?
Yeah, no, I saw. I was too busy killing fools, Invicta. Jeez.
Ryze is still alive somehow, but at least you got the kill. I'm gonna finish off Athene's, maybe. Should probably finish off my boots too. So
All right, now
that definitely brought us back in this game.
Yeah, I'm glad we are no longer losing the 4v5. That makes me feel better.
Your CS is at 99. You are now number one, sir.
Wait until my seeds take root.
CS number one. Oh, someone's teleporting up here.
It's Kog'Maw. I am on the way back. You could probably stand to go back to heal and buy anything you need right now while there's a little bit of downtime.
Yeah, I do have lots of money.
Is that a diving board?
Yeah, dude, you just noticed that? He fucking dives around, man. I know, it's pretty random.
I never even saw that. Who the
I'll
hell...
just buy whatever this is because I can afford it.
Who the hell warded here? It's weird. Whatever. I've never seen that diving board. That's pretty funny, though. Just gotta say. We should be able to take the middle, their tier 1 turret here. I'm definitely worried about them backdooring us from the river. They may actually be on Dragon or Baron right now.
Yeah, I don't know.
Nope, wait, here they come. Here they come. Run. No, we gotta fight this. We can't let our.
Yeah, I'll be showing up here momentarily, but.
I'm gonna ult them all. And, that was huge damage on Pantheon. Down goes Pantheon. Pantheon's down. Here comes Fiddlesticks. Be careful of Fiddlesticks. Kog'Maw and Ryze is actually gonna live, but Kog'Maw back away. Run, Husky. No, run, Husky. Run. Okay, he's gonna kill Pantheon. Oh, maybe not. So that went really good for our team. Like, really super good. And I'm going to check to see if I can steal their blue buff.
Take careful steps.
I'm coming with you.
Yeah, if you could tank it. Actually, if you're going to be here, then I'm going to let you take it. Now it's
not there.
Let's go ahead and push this tower over here while we're here.
Oh.
They're just
apparently they quit.
Why did they quit?
I guess they didn't want to play with the guy down, and also I was unstoppable. Is all it comes down to.
Was that an actual 5v4 that entire game?
Yeah, you can see their Warwick was level 1.
Oh, okay.
But hey, I'm happy with it, and I feel like listening to Dyrus actually paid off. I actually understood this guy a little bit.
Yeah, support Zyra is actually kind of fun. I don't mind it. So I'm gonna give Husky the honor. He's gonna be a friendly teammate. And again, Husky, thank you very much for helping me with this try hard. We didn't have to try too hard, but I feel like we've all grown a little bit more after this.
I think so. I think for, you know, playing in the, I don't even think they're called placement matches, the warm-up matches, they're good for you. Even if it ends up being 5v4, even if your team is down a player, I think it's still really, really good practice, because now I feel a little bit more comfortable with Graves. And yeah, I think I'm going to keep playing him for tryhard. He's a lot of fun. So thank you, Sinvicta, for joining in.
Yeah, of course. I'm looking forward to supporting you more. And I just got to say, good job on the CS. You dominated that game.
Wait, actually, what did I get? 107. All right, not bad. I definitely did better than the guy who never joined the game. So that's that's a step in the right direction. Anyways, guys, go follow Sinvicta. He's got a YouTube channel where he makes videos, and I guess that's what you do. So that's all I have to say about you.
Thank you very much, Husky.
All right, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoy it, and I'll see you guys next time.